Sanjo and Momo are over. After 14 tournaments playing together, the tournament in Paris here in Roland Garros are gonna be the last for them. From the next tournament in Madrid, each one will play with a new partner. What happened here and with whom will each of them play? Hello tour players, I'm Pablo and I welcome you to a new four-set here in Paris in Roland Garros. It seems like a long time ago, but 2023 started with Sanjo playing with Bella and Momo playing with Alex Ruiz. And if you remember, Sanjo told in some interviews that he said no in many occasions to Momo to play together. But finally, a couple that promised 100% of magic combining youth and experience became a reality. And the star of the couple almost could not be better. On their first tournament in Brussels, they managed to reach the semifinals and said this.
Desde el primer partido, desde el primer entrenamiento, siento que hay una conexión especial que yo no lo veía enfrente, pero ahora lo que lo tengo al lado interpreta mi juego a la perfección. Yo, la verdad, tengo suerte de leerle también los tiros a él. Y creo que por momentos se lo dije, en un momento del partido, le digo, ahora mismo somos una maquinita que está jugando al pádel. Sin fallos, contundentes, con un despliegue físico impresionante, sobre todo de él, no mío, pero muy punzantes en el ataque, muy, muy firmes en la defensa. Nos miramos, nos entendemos, nos comunicamos bien, lo que decimos logramos hacerlo y creo que me sorprendió tanto afuera como adentro de la pista el nivel de Momo realmente.
Lo que dice él, nos complementamos muy bien para el poco tiempo que llevamos. Yo, es verdad que es muy fácil jugar con él, al final te hace ver el pádel muy muy sencillo. Cuando hay detalles pequeños, ese detalle te lo explica y te hace cambiar y te hace mejorar, así que muy contento de cómo nos está yendo.
By the way, if you like paddle, look at this, we are in Roland Garros, so please subscribe to the channel. The chemistry between the two was very positive and the results promise a lot from this couple. From that first semi-finals in Brussels, one more will come in Vigo to finally reach their first final as a couple in Denmark, losing against the Super Pibes. Three tournaments, two semi-finals, one final, not bad results to start as a couple. Especially for Momo, who was not used to play on those last rounds. Vienna would come and they lost in the round of 16 against Coqui Nieto and John Sanz. And remember this couple. They are the unfortunate protagonists of this story. However, the defeat in Vienna would be a mirage because immediately afterwards they would lose a new final in Marbella against Coello and Tapia. But then, everything changed. Valladolid, Sanjo's home for several years, will see a defeat in the first round of a master tournament against Garrido and Campagnolo. It's not easy to play against Garrido and Campagnolo, it was an understood defeat, but anyways, it hurts a lot. So obviously at that time the couple was not going through their best moment. But if the defeat in Valladolid hurts, later came what I think is the most painful one for Sanjo and Momo as a couple. After not having played in Rome last year, Sanjo played this year with Momo against Lamperti and Denis Perino in the first round. And no one expected it, but it happens. Sanjo and Momo lost. Was it the end of Sanjo and Momo?
Llamé a mi mujer, llamé a mi gente cercana y le dije, tengo dos sensaciones contradictorias totalmente. Una es, me vuelvo a Alicante, no toco la pala hasta Madrid, no hago nada hasta Madrid. Y desconecto, me voy a caminar a la playa, escucho el mar y si puedo hago meditación. O la otra, le propongo a Momo venirnos a Madrid y hacer doble turno todos los días. Pues todos me dijeron, y yo mismo el doble turno. Nos vinimos a Madrid, jugamos 6 partidos en 3 días contra distintos rivales, probamos muchas cosas. Y empezó a salir de vuelta, por lo menos en entrenamiento, empezó a salir de vuelta esa versión que habíamos encontrado al principio del proyecto. Y creo que hoy estamos los dos más contentos y más convencidos de que podemos volver a jugar bien.
¿Por qué estáis convencidos?
Porque hemos encontrado alguna cosa que funciona. Yo lo que más me estaba costando asimilar en la pareja es que no teníamos una identidad. Yo veo parejas consolidadas, que están haciendo buenos resultados y los veo con un esquema de juego. Yo salgo a jugar contra ellos y digo, me van a jugar así. Pues nosotros no, nosotros estábamos perdidos. ¿A qué jugamos? Si yo le decía a Momo, si yo te pregunto a qué jugamos, ¿a qué jugamos?
No hay respuesta.
No había respuesta.
Despite those painful defeats, Sanjo and Momo had not considered to break their project.
En ningún momento se pensó en separarse, no. No estamos separados.
las redes tienen su parte buena y su parte mala, y han logrado, en base a tratar de apoyar, y me gusta porque la gente a veces confunde lo que puede ser un apoyo hacia Momo o un apoyo hacia mí, siendo crítico con el otro. No, no, Sancho te habla mal, Sancho no te esto, Sancho humildad, le falta humildad, Sancho no te da, Sancho no sé qué, no sé cuánto. No lo estás ayudando. No lo estás ayudando porque nosotros nos elegimos y nos seguimos eligiendo para jugar juntos. Y si yo hablo de esa manera o yo comunico de esa manera, es porque está hablado en el equipo y que yo sea el que comunica. Y a veces, un líder no siempre parece el bueno.
They managed to recover their best feelings through hard work in Madrid, but they will lose again in Málaga against Coqui and John Sanz, and in Mendoza against LeBron and Galán. After holidays in August, the results would not come again. And here we are in Paris, where Sanjo and Momo lost in the round of 16 again, Coqui Nieto and John Sanz. Remember that Coqui and John made the final last week in Finland. They are actually a super couple and this thing can happen. However, Sanjo and Momo said that enough is enough. So 14 tournaments later, Sanjo and Momo part ways. Sanjo has chosen not to continue with the project and put an end to his adventure with Momo in Paris. But from my point of view, there is one thing clear. They have tried everything. They have tried 1000 strategies, they have tried 1000 tactics, they have worked harder when things were worse, but it has not worked out. If after putting all your efforts the results don't come, I don't think it's a bad idea to part ways. Do you think that Sanjo and Momo are doing the right thing breaking up? Sanjo, by taking the decision to separate from Momo, has his future clearer than Momo. And everything is going to be in the family because Sanjo is gonna play with his nephew Agustín El Oveja Gutiérrez. It may sound strange, but in my opinion, it's normal. Firstly, because at the moment there are no top couples willing to separate. And secondly, because Sanjo has always wanted to play with his nephew. And on top of that, both of them train in Ekelite, so they can quickly add many hours of court time together. However, now Momo is in an uncomfortable situation. He doesn't have a close partner and most probably he will have to break another couple. And one thing that comes to my mind is that Momo is thinking about to play on the right side of the court. Who do you think will Momo play with? Do you see Sanjo signing with Agustín? Thank you for watching the video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel here in Paris, in Roland Garros. See ya!